Hi, I'm Darren, this is Tom. We work for Kensa's technical department, and today we're going to show you how to roll out a 30 metre slinky. When a slinky turns up on site, it usually comes on a pallet looking like this, with a clear cellophane wrap around the outside. On the inside, we've got four flat strap bands, which connect the slinky to the pallet. They will each need to be cut. The cellophane wrap will need to come off, and then we'll show you how to roll the slinky out. Tom's just about to unwrap this one. He's literally going to cut down through the cellophane wrap with a Stanley knife, just taking care not to slice the slinky. Tom is just going to remove the four strap bands that connect the slinky to the pallet. Okay, so now the slinky is disconnected from the pallet, we're just going to lift it into place and show you how to roll it out. We've got the slinky ready to lay out, but before we start, we're just going to cut the transport cable tie, which purely is there for transport, just to stop that flapping around. And what you can see on this end is a purple cable tie. Now this denotes the return of the slinky. Okay, it's purple because this is a 30 metre slinky. If you've got a 40 metre slinky, this is in green. And if you've got a 50 metre slinky, this will be coloured yellow. Okay, and that denotes the return pipe. We're going to stand the slinky up, get it into place, and for this exercise we are at the furthest point of the trench, furthest point away from the house, and we're heading back towards the manifold. First thing we want to do is remove these strap bands. What we're going to do now is remember the side with the purple cable tie, which is the return. And we're going to remove the return until we come to the first black cable tie, which is where the slinky starts, which is there. I'm going to remove this and put it behind the trench and down out of the way. So now we've removed the return and we've put it behind our trench. What you'll see is where the slinky starts. The slinkies are pre-made in the factory, so all the cable ties are in place and all the loops have been pre-formed to the same size. Okay, so we're about to roll the slinky out and back down towards the manifold. As we come to the end of the slinky there, that's the last loop. We're just going to remove, roll out the header pipe and just leave it to one side for the moment. And we'll come back to that in a minute. That is the header flow. We're just going to put that on the ground and come back and check the slinky. And what is really important now to do is just to make sure none of these loops are overlapping each other. Okay, really important that they're separated and not overlapping. Okay, so we've rolled this slinky out. We're now going to come back to the return, okay? And what Tom's going to do now is cable tie the return back down, all the way down the side of the slinky, okay? And as you can see, it's got the 55 metre return with the purple cable tie on the end. And this is where two of you can be really helpful. This is where first guy can put cable tie on and just get it secured in place. So we've started to roll the return down now, and we've put in a couple of cable ties just to hold it together. And what is really important to remember is that that roll there can't be just pulled away from the slinky. It needs to be rolled. And the reason for that is because it will kink. If it gets kinked, the damage is going to have to be cut out and repaired with electrofusion welded coupling. So pain in the backside, you don't want to do it. So make sure you roll your slinky out. So now we've finished rolling out the return next to the slinky, and we have actually cable tied it to all the loops all the way down. But at this point, it's important to remember that you've got 25 metres of return there that needs to reach a manifold. If it's not likely to reach the manifold, your manifold's 30 metres away, you'll need an extra 5 metres. And the way we do that is by cutting some of the cable ties right at the beginning of the return before you put all your cable ties on, and just pull your pipe out and just make sure it's going to reach a manifold. Okay, if your manifold's nearer than 25 metres and it comes up short, then fantastic. we can loop some of the pipework over the slinky until it connects straight up onto the manifold. What's really important, and is a bit of a golden rule with Kensa, is don't cut a slinky, okay? If you cut a slinky and you don't cut another one, then they're gonna be unbalanced and you won't get equal flow down both. Okay, so when we supply the slinkies, they come with cap ends that obviously prevent dirt, anything else going into the slinky. Make sure they stay in. By all means, put some tape over the top of them as well, just a bit of extra protection. Also to remember, the type of trench you're laying your slinky in, if there's sharp stones in there, anything sharp, you will need something like a sand blinding or something purely for protection of the pipe. Okay, has nothing, sand has no benefit on thermal conductivity, it's purely for protection of that slinky. Okay, so just a quick recap for you on the color cable ties. So yellow is a 50 meter slinky, green is a 40 meter slinky, and purple is a 30 meter slinky. For more information on sizing, spacing, design, or installation of your slinkies, please by all means go to our website, which is www.kensaheatpumps.com. Go to the Knowledge Hub, a little tab called the Knowledge Hub. There is plenty of information on there. Or failing that, give me a ring.